how long would it take us to go to Venus? Venus is the brightest planet in our sky. In fact, it's just in the list of brightest objects after the Sun and the Moon. Also known as a twin of our planet Earth, exploration of Venus has been one of the most important planetary objectives after Mars. Humanity has sent many missions to the morning star, but the mysteries around the planet are still to be answered. And to answer those questions, we need to first go there. So how long would it take us to go to Venus? It's full of scientific marvels, such as being the hottest planet in our solar system and having 92 times the surface pressure of Earth. We have sent several unmanned expeditions to Venus, but we have yet to set foot on its surface. When considering an accomplishment like this, there are several elements to consider. There is also a question about humans terraforming Venus. How long would a manned mission to Venus be? In this video, we will answer all of that and more. The Sun is the brightest object in our sky because it is a huge ball of fire. The Moon is bright because it is incredibly close and reflects the light from the Sun. But Venus is bright for two main reasons: its highly reflective atmosphere and its very close distance to Earth. So what is the distance of Venus from Earth? Let's talk about that first. We all know planets follow an elliptical orbit. All the planets follow their orbits, and because of this type, distances between them might vary. They might be closest at a certain point of time, and they might be farthest too. So there is no one distance between Earth and Venus. You will observe Venus to be on the opposite side of the Sun from us when it reaches superior conjunction. The largest distance between the two planets is when the Earth is at the extreme end of its orbital ellipse. In the same manner, they are closest to each other at the inferior conjunction, which happens every 584 days. This is the point at which Earth, Venus, and the Sun all align, with Venus and Earth on opposite sides of the Sun. The closest Venus can get to Earth is when it passes through the least curved region of Earth's orbit. This occurs when the Earth is close to perihelion, its closest approach to the Sun. The orbits of both the planets are mathematically linked and repeat almost perfectly at every 5 conjunctions, which last for around 8 years. This indicates that the distance between Earth and Venus at each conjunction will be roughly the same after 5 conjunctions. With all this information under our belt, we know that there is no one answer to the question of how far away is Venus. But we do know its closest, farthest, and average distance from us. As we mentioned above, all planets orbit in an ellipse, rather than a circle. But Venus has the most circular orbit. The average distance between the planet and the Sun is 67 million miles, or 108 million kilometers. Venus is closest to Earth at its inferior conjunction, where it is just 25 million miles, or 40 million kilometers distant at its closest, perihelion. Because of changes in Earth's orbit throughout time, the minimum distance between our two planets has risen. Since 1623, Venus has been no closer to Earth than 24.5 million miles, or 39.5 million kilometers. Venus will not approach within 24.8 million miles, or 40 million kilometers of Earth, for more than 60,000 years after the year 5683. Venus's closest and farthest approaches occur only every 19 months or so. Between times, its average distance from Earth is around 42.2 million miles, or 68 million kilometers. This isn't the whole story, because the distance to Venus changes every day and fluctuates greatly over each orbit. But it's a good starting point. Venus is even closer to Earth than Mars. Scientists today think that Venus had habitable conditions a few billion years ago, until a runaway greenhouse effect caused by volcanic activity and water loss from Venus's atmosphere. This process sentenced Venus to its current terrible landscape. Because of many reasons and mysteries like this, the Morning Star has been a prominent target for space missions. With the first space missions launched by Soviets and Americans in the early space race in the 1960s, both the countries sent various spacecraft to the hellish planet in the space race. Out of the 41 missions launched to Venus since the advent of the space era, 23, American and Soviet, have successfully traveled to Venus, counting all of those that flew past Venus without being dedicated to studying it. This success rate easily exceeds the success rate of missions to Mars. These spacecraft, which have been sent to Venus, can offer valuable insights on how much time it takes to reach it. The Venera 1 spacecraft by the Soviet Union was the first space probe to be launched towards Venus. The mission was launched on February 12, 1961, with the primary goal of reaching the planet. However, on February 17th, scientists lost touch with the space probe. Because mission controllers did not have time to make a course correction that would have brought it closer to Venus, it is believed to have passed within 100,000 kilometers of the planet on May 19th. That's a total of 97 days, or a little more than 3 months. NASA's Mariner 2 completed the first successful Venus flyby. This spacecraft was launched on August 8, 1962, and successfully completed a flyby on December 14, 1962. So the total time from launch to arrival at Venus is 110 days. The Pioneer Venus 1 mission was launched on May 20, 1978, and arrived at its destination in 198 days. ESA's Venus Express was the most recent spacecraft to visit Venus. It was launched on November 9, 2005 and traveled to Venus in 153 days. Why is there such a difference between the time taken by different spacecraft? Traveling to the planet in a spacecraft is not an easy task. It's not feasible to simply determine its location, point a spacecraft at it, and click the huge launch button. Instead, we must account for the movement of the planets as they orbit the Sun. We must also avoid our own gravitational pull at the beginning of our voyage, and enter Venus's at the finish. It all comes down to several factors like the route, fuel efficiency, and others. Let's take a look at some of these. All of this is like a physics ballet. Often the best path to our destination is not the most direct, which adds to the time it takes to get there. It all boils down to launch velocity and trajectory. The Earth and Venus are both in orbits around the Sun. In order to reach the morning star, you must travel in a transfer orbit between Earth's orbit and Venus's orbit, catching up with Venus and ideally entering orbit. To accomplish the journey with a smaller, less costly rocket, you must take a longer, more time-consuming route. Another important factor to consider is the sort of engine driving the spacecraft, whether it is fuel-efficient or not. And a third factor to consider is that slowing down takes a long time. So if a spacecraft is only going to fly by, it must slow down. But if it's going to orbit, its voyage to Venus will take longer. So because of this, it is very clear that there is no one answer for how long it would take to reach Venus. It all depends on a variety of factors. But based on the history of missions to Jupiter, the shortest time a spacecraft took was 109 days, and the longest was 198 days. On an average, missions to Jupiter take between 120 to 135 days. But what about humans going to Venus? Terraforming it has been an important topic for discussion lately. If Venus was once habitable, could it be made habitable again? To be honest, the process would be really hard because of the planet's hellish atmosphere, but certain ways can allow the terraforming of Venus. But that's a topic for another video. Today we want to talk about whether a human mission to Venus would be possible. Humans have never made the trip, but someday we can expect at least a flyby mission, as landing on the planet itself would be very unpleasant. The only probes that landed safely on Venus and sent back images of its surface area were Venera 9 and Venera 10, which lasted for 53 minutes and 65 minutes respectively. The surface temperature of Venus can reach up to 950 degrees Fahrenheit, not to mention thousands of volcanoes and a planet like an oven. Simply surviving on Venus's surface would necessitate technology that could endure tremendous heat and corrosion from sulfuric acid in the atmosphere, not to mention the strain on the human body. Humanity will send several unmanned expeditions to the planet. Even so, machines can only retrieve so much data and information. We'll arrive at a moment in time when our next move will be to set foot on the planet. There are a few basic properties of Venus that fascinate astronomers all around the world. The fact that there is a layer of atmosphere in which humanity may exist, and that the planet's rocky surface is similar to Earth's. We can just imagine what a human landing on Venus would look like. On an average, with the best of our spacecrafts, We could even shorten the journey to 60 to 80 days in the future with better engines and propulsion systems. But only time will tell. What do you think about going to Venus? When will humanity try a manned mission there? Any estimates? Let us know what you think in the comment section below, and share the video with your friends.